I think it is safe to say that R. Kelly was probably the king of R&B at one time. Yeah, definitely up there, top three. I don't know who else can you say was on his level, really. You know, an individual on R. Kelly's level. We can I think Jodeci and man there are a bit too early for him or whatever. I don't think Jagged Edge were that you know, as good as R. Kelly. I think, yeah, R. Kelly probably was, like, could have been the king of R&B at his time, you know, during his era, definitely. Yeah, he is a disgrace, man, for real, man. Like, brother, these man really need to check, fam, you're a fucking celebrity, yeah? We all know, not all celebrities get gyal, yeah? But R. Kelly was one of them, man. Yeah, so the screen from moving. R. Kelly was one of them, man. Women will be throwing themselves at him. Yeah? There are certain celebrities out there, no matter how much money they got, women, they just ain't into them like that. But he's one of them, man, there, who women will be throwing themselves at him. Yeah? Nah, I don't want all you women. I'd rather go out with some, deal with some girls who are underage. Yeah? I don't like nothing over 16 years old, sorry, or 17 or 18 years old, yeah? He's a fucking stupid, a man who would have had his pick of women, yeah? Imagine back in the days when he was coming up, yeah? Back in the 90s and that. Imagine there was Instagram, yeah? And women could be DMing him. Obviously, back in those days, them man just go to the club and they need security to stop women from trying to take them home or whatever, innit? Yeah? But imagine with social media as well. Yeah, imagine how much more women would have been on him. And then to what? Go and throw that away on some little fucking teenager, little kid. It must be that Justin Squares getting bored of women. Yeah, must be. I know R. Kelly, back in his heyday, yeah? Back in the heyday when he was coming up in the 90s and that, he must have been mashing up these women. So you know what? You know, certain of these men, like these celebrities or whoever, innit? You're like, you always hear about one or two times, like these footballers, right? They kind of turn homosexual because it's like almost like they get so much women, yeah, they're bored with it, yeah? Do you not remember hearing about Eddie Murphy got caught with a fucking transsexual in the back of a limousine? I'm sure back in the day, Eddie Murphy got caught with a transsexual in the back of a limousine, and I'm sure he was with Mel B at the time as well. So you go and cheat on Mel B with a fucking transsexual in the back of a fucking limousine, and I swear he was high on crack or cocaine or something like that. I think certain men, they get so much girls, they just turn mad. Yeah, they think, you know what, I'm so bored with women, let me try out and see what it's like with a man. You know, I wouldn't be surprised about Hugh Grant, to be fair. Yeah, I'm sure I'm sure Eddie Murphy got caught in the back of a limousine with a transsexual back in the day. We're talking like early 2000s, maybe late 90s, innit? One of the two, innit? And I'm sure he was high on crack or cocaine, innit, at the time, innit? Now, that ain't no fucking excuse. I don't give a fuck what I'm on. I could be on fucking horse tranquilizer, yeah? You ain't catching me with no transsexual or no next man in the back of no limousine, yeah? Even on horse tranquilizer, yeah? Right, yeah, so basically, on May the 2nd, 1997, this fucking hell. So not only was he with a transsexual, but he was with a transsexual or transgender prostitute. Fucking hell. But yeah, so Eddie Murphy got stopped by the police with a transsexual transsexual prostitute in his car. Boy, I don't know what to say, fam. See, a lot of these stories, you know, like you hear like these dumb things back in the day, you kind of, but later in life, you kind of remember, oh shit, my man got caught with a fucking transsexual in the back of his car. Yeah? Certain man just turned mad. I don't know, like, what's going on for them? Like, think it's probably too much women, and they just feel, you know, I just can't swing the other way. Yeah, women, they don't do it for me no more. And I would never get to that stage, I'm telling you. Yeah, never get to that stage, boy. Like, if I was them, man, there's no way I could get bored of women. I'd be like, I need to lick down all of these fucking Instagram models, yeah? I need to lick these, I need to knock these girls down, yeah? Like, I just won't stop.